there. Welcome back to Creator on Wheels, and I hope you guys are doing happy and healthy. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾತ್ಮಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ಹೊಸ ಸಂಚಿಕೆಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಆದರದ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ 25th of March ಟುಡೇ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ಡೇಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ಡೈಲೆಮಾ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ. ಲಾಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, ಲಾಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. Everything is related to travel. Okay, now to go back in time, exactly 1 year back, it's like exactly 1 year back, 25th of March 2020 was a festival day. It was Yugadi, but just 5 days prior to that, I mean coinciding 5 days prior to that, I think 28th of March was when I had planned for a first big ride on my Java 42, or Dusky as I call her. The plan was for me and a friend of mine from Mysore, who is also a Java owner. We wanted to go towards Bangalore and then do a coastal ride and then come back from interior Karnataka. Our plan was for about 4 days, and we had thought like we'll come back by 24th evening or something like that, so by the festival time we will be back home. Just a day before the ride, just 1 day before the ride, so I'm talking about 20th, when the world kind of looked like okay, but it was not okay. So by 13th of March the IT world had already gone into that work from home mindset, but 20th of March, when we had finalized the route, where we're going to stay, everything, somehow, some kind of like an intuition struck us, like, okay, we should not be going ahead with this trip. I don't know why. Like, he had one personal issue from his side. He was, anytime during March, April time is when he was expecting his first kid. So he was like in half a mind, like whether he should be away from home during that situation. But somewhere, like for both of us, we just thought like, okay, should we really go ahead with this? And that was exactly the time when we had zero fear or zero knowledge about what would happen to us, to this country, to this world. We called it off. We actually called off the trip. We stayed back. And I think 23rd of March is when the entire country went on a lockdown. And a lot of things have changed since then. Now, fast forward to today, 25th of March 2021. Situation seems to be creeping back to similar state. Now, when I go back in time, we hardly had like double digit number of cases in India as of 25th of March. I don't even think it has like gone beyond 15 or 20. I don't think so it was even beyond 10. But the idea was to lock down the country so that the virus does not spread. We hardly had a handful of people who were infected, and most, if not for all of them, had come from outside. Now, that was a time when the fear was maximum, the risk was least. I told this in the past also. March 2020 was a time when the fear was maximum, the risk was least among the people. Now, fast forward to today, it's totally a different case right now. We, again, like according to the government, according to the health officials, we are now in the so-called second wave. I don't know if it is the fifth second wave or sixth second wave, but yeah, according to them, this is the second wave. We are literally seeing about 1,000 cases per day in Karnataka, and again the deaths are on the rise and all those stuff. Now again, I'll come back to this whole numbers and statistics part in just a bit, but the cases are very high, the risk is very high. Okay, the chances of somebody traveling somewhere to a public gathering and he or she getting infected or being the bearer of the virus is high now. But the fear has reduced drastically. When I say drastically, I'm going to go and tell it has become zero. So much has changed since maybe lockdown one, sorry, Unlock 1. The lot has changed since Unlock 2. It has come to a stage wherein there is hardly any shop or any place which keeps sanitizer now. Though government every day, the BBMP every day, everyone is continuously telling sanitize your hand, keep maintain social distancing, everything. Social distancing has become zero. And even though people want to do all this cleanliness stuff and all, you go to shops, I would say 8 or 9 out of the shops are not even bothering keeping hand sanitizers in the entrance, no temperature checks whatsoever, and in the remaining 2 shops, it is empty bottles. In fact, like today morning, I went to a temple, and this is the exact same temple which about 6 months back, they told very strictly, kids are not allowed, aged people are not allowed inside the temple. They were very strict about it. And I had to carry my kid and stand on the road until my wife went in and finished the puja and come back. Now, fast forward to today, there is a, I would call it as like a rusted sanitizer bottle, which I don't think so had been topped up since last 2 to 3 months. It was in such situation. Nobody to check temperature, nothing. No, it was not crowded, and again, Thursday is not a day when I was expecting it to be crowded, but the religious institutes are some place which is a hub. Literally, I'll tell you, if something has to spread really bad, it has to be during religious events. I'm not talking about specific communities, I'm not talking about specific religions, but we know it does not matter if it is a Hindu festival, whether it's a Muslim gathering or it's a Christian mass or whatever. The religious festivals are when people just go in numbers, literally in numbers. So the fear has become literally zero and the risk is high. The cases in Maharashtra are increasing exponentially, a lot of places in North India it's increasing exponentially, but the travel is opening up. A lot of people, I'm seeing a lot of people are like going ahead with their vacation plans, travel plans, summer vacations, all those things. People are planning for Goa, people are planning for Andaman. And like 1 year since me cancelling my, what could have been my first major long ride in my bike, I'm still not getting that whole confidence factor that I should now go ahead and do a trip to places which is far. I have gone out on travel purpose probably two or three times since the last 6 months with my family, but I was extremely cautious and I was extremely careful when I'm selecting the place and when I'm deciding where I will stay and where all I will go. I used to intentionally handpick hotels or resorts where I was staying which are expensive so that very less people come, because cost factor is one thing which will avoid people going to expensive resorts. And again, the situation, financial situation of many people are not that great, so people would refrain from spending a lot of money. I mean, I'm talking about 6 months ago or 3 months ago. So I used to be very cautious. Now, when I want to go to places which is like a very touristy, very general places, I'm still not able to get out of that fear. I don't know if it is just me or whatever, but I see a lot of people around me have made up their mind and started traveling, started exploring. If they are careful, if they are safe, I'm very happy for them. I'm not telling what they're doing is wrong. But that's what I'm telling you. The last 1 week when I started thinking about should I go out, should I go out, somehow I'm not getting that confidence factor. So people who are listening, I mean, you guys need to tell me whether what is the situation in your mind? What is the situation in your house? Like, are they okay with you going out? Are you okay with going out? Some of you might be staying with your family. Some of you might be staying with your aged parents. Are you comfortable going out and then coming back with 100% confidence that, okay, fine, I'm safe. My parents will be safe and all. I don't know. I probably still need some time. I'm okay going out on a full day ride on a Saturday or Sunday, maybe even on a weekday, I don't mind taking a day off and traveling, but going and staying somewhere, going and visiting touristy places, I'm still not 100% sure about that. Now, having spoken about this numbers and all those things, there is a different ball game altogether. As most of you know, vaccinations are already there and it is available for people above 60 years of age. And apparently, another 5 or 6 days from now, that is 1st of April, the government is telling that it will be available for 45 plus also. But let me honestly tell you, I have not gone ahead for the vaccination for my parents with the fear that I don't have enough justification and I don't have enough substantiation from the outside world. I'm not talking about any single person or an organization or anyone, that the vaccination is safe for everyone. It's been the research is just like 3 or 6 months old. There isn't enough data. We don't know what is the long-term implications of this vaccine and all the stuff. But there is a push from people, and people have started thinking that taking vaccination means they will not get corona at all. No, that's absolutely wrong. That's absolutely wrong, because there are enough number of cases in Bangalore, in Karnataka, across India, wherein people, the frontline workers who have already taken 2 doses of the vaccine, but still they're tested positive for the virus. So the vaccine is not something like you take the vaccine and you'll never get it. There are chances that you will get it. There are probably, I would say, still high chances that you will get it. But the risk or the aftermath of you getting, or you facing the consequences, might be slightly small, but we don't know. Most of the people who have got, who have tested positive even after taking the, wait a second. Most of the people who are tested positive after taking the second dose of vaccination are typically the frontline workers, like doctors or the folks who are in the Paurakarmika kind of people. They are not like somebody who is beyond 60, 70 age group. So we don't know what happens if a person who is above 60, who has taken the vaccination but still get the virus, which still catch the virus, what is the implications? What is the magnitude of implication? I don't know. And what are the side effects? No. Everyone keep on telling nothing. Everyone says that, okay, on that day or the next day, you will get fever, which is very typical of a vaccine, irrespective of the age group. They say a slight hand pain for a few days or like body pain for a few days. But that is hardly 1% or less than 1% of what could be the cases. I'm not telling there will be side effects. I'm not at all from a medical field. But for somebody who has worked for a very short period of time in health sciences software application and kind of little bit know how the whole medicine research works and how the data points are collected, how long the data points are collected before approving a medicine, I feel this is more of like a hurried decision to play safe. And again, I don't want to start up any kind of a controversy or anything, or any kind of a negative discussion around it, but I think it's everything to do with money. Inducing fear, inducing unnecessary confidence in people, and thereby driving business. Because it might be 250 rupees for a dose, like 500 rupees for the vaccination over a period of 1 month, but we are talking about lakhs of people, we are talking about millions of people across India. So it's a big, big business model. And again, there is a competition between multiple companies or brands, and again, who is favored, who is not favored, all those things are there. And again, there are people, again, from the medical fraternity itself, I have spoken to quite a lot of them over the last few weeks, and they kind of confidently tell this whole second wave thing is a psychological game that government and all are playing against the people. So the moment you say more cases, you will force yourself to think, okay, let me go and take vaccination and all those things. And again, that will drive vaccination business and all those stuff. And again, this is also a case, like, I mean, you would have heard, or same time last year when people were starting tested positive for corona, like probably I would say 10 months back or something, some of those people were not even someone who had tested positive, but there were a lot of hospitals who were wrongly certifying that person needs to be admitted even if he had a common cold, and put a huge bill on that person after like 5 days or 7 days of making him admitted in a ICU. So all those things are there. Is it a scam and all those things? I don't want to commit. I don't want to tell that that is the case. But this is a thing which is known to all of them. But again, I'm just playing around with the same set of words. Like, is it really safe? Is it true? Is it safe? Is it okay to go out now? Is it okay to be normal now? Should we still live in the fear? How long are we going to live in the fear? That's the whole question that is bothering me. And especially in my case, considering that I have a small kid and aged parents in my house, me going out, I probably, instead of like earlier, if I used to think twice before all this corona time, now I'm thinking like 100 times. Should I do it? Shouldn't I do it? So that's the kind of situation, that's the kind of world that we're living in, that's the kind of the world that it has been set up for us. I mean, it's sometimes it feels very evident that people are making things happen, people are creating the fear and all. But again, it's end of the day, it's all our decision. You want to be safe, you want to be home, you can be, you want to go out, you can still be safe, please do. You want to go out, you want to take chances, please do that also. So it's all individual decision. You have to be safe, you have to be cautious about the decisions that you take. So I just thought I'll talk a little bit about it, because I'm pretty sure a lot of people who are probably seeing this or listening to this also have this kind of like a confusion in their mind. I'm still not sure, I'm still not convinced when is the next time I'm going out on a very normal touristy mindset, but time will tell. I mean, I don't want to make any hurried decision or anything, but time will tell. So that's it what I wanted to talk about. Hope it was not boring, hope it was not too much of a gyan, but whatever is the case, I will probably catch you back again in a few days from now. So until then, take care, bye bye, Mata Sigana.